All right, so we're going to move on to Haralambos, which is allotrope. Adventures of Gregory Peccary.
The Adventures of Gregory Peccary.
Oh, here comes Gregory, little Gregory Peccary. The nocturnal gregarious wild swine.
A peccary is a little pig with a white collar that usually hangs around between Texas and Paraguay, sometimes ranging as far west as Catalina.
What?
Catalina.
This particular peccary is part of that bold new breed that extinguishes itself by markings which resemble a wide tie directly below the white collar.
If it's wide enough, everyone will know that the tie I'm wearing is a symbol of how nimble my mind will go.
Swing, suave.
Oh, wow. It sounds like a cartoon. Okay, just real quick, I gotta acknowledge, I know who Gregory Peck is. You know, I've seen the freaking movie, a few of his movies. Was it Mr. Smith? Is that? No, that's the other person, Jimmy Stewart. Gregory Peck, I think I've only seen To Kill a Mockingbird. I think that's the only Gregory Peck movie I've seen. Name some others, dude. But here, Gregory Peccary is a pig with a very big, long tail.
Drives his little red Volkswagen to the ugly part of town where they keep the government buildings.
Wooden.
Thank you.
it's so hard to find a place to park around here. Run, 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 run.
Gregory Peckery takes the elevator up to the 83rd floor of a grim, gray, evil-looking building with a sign on the front reading... Big Swifty and Associates, Trendmongers. And what, might you ask, is a trendmonger? Well, a trendmonger is a person who dreams up a trend. Like the twist. Or flower power. And spreads it throughout the land using all the frightening little skills that science has made available.
How do you even, like, write something like this, dude? Like, how do you even, like, keep this in your brain and then express it onto, like... There's so many moving parts to this. There's too many, dude. He had to have some help, right? Or is Frank just, like, another, like, Mozart, dude? I mean, I'm starting to believe Frank's just a Mozart incarnate, dude. Wow. This is, like, insane. Let's keep it going.
And so it was, one fateful morning, Gregory Peckery made his way through the steno pool.
Hi, Mildred. Hello, Gladys. Wanda.
Yes, from the moment they laid eyes on him, all the girls in the big Swifty steno pool knew here was a nocturnal gregarious wild swine on his way up. A peccary of destiny, adventure, and romance.
Is there any mail for me? Would you rather be involved in a series of colorful time-wasting trends?
Sure.
Air hockey. Big dush.
La 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 la. Yo 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 yo. Is your wife snoring by the sea?
Does it matter that this waste of time is what makes a life for you?
I must plummet boldly forward to my ultra-affine, laminated, simulated replica mahogany desk with a strategically placed imported very hip water pipe and the latest edition of the Whole Earth Catalog and rack my agile mind for a spectacular new trend, thereby rejuvenating our limping economy and providing for bored, miserable people everywhere some great new thing to identify with. Busy making them just for you. Yoo-hoo! Highly efficient and
Gregory turned and strode nonchalantly into his dinky little office with the desk and the catalog and the very hip water pipe, and proceeded with a vigor and determination known only to piglets of a similarly diminutive proportion to single-handedly invent the calendar. With his eyes rolled heavenward and his little shiny pig hoofs on the desk, Gregory ponders the question of eternity and fractional divisions thereof, as mysterious angelic voices sing to him from a great distance, providing the necessary clues for the construction of his thrilling new trend.
Sunday, wow. Sunday, Saturday, Tuesday through, Monday. Sunday, Saturday,
and thus the calendar in all of its colorful disguises was presented to the bored and miserable people everywhere. Gregory issued a memo on it, whereupon the entire contents of the steno pool identified with it strenuously and worshipped it as a way of life, and took their little pills by it, and went back and forth from work by it, and paid their rent by it, and before long they were even having birthday parties in the office by it. Because now at last, Gregory Peccary's exciting new invention had made it possible for everyone to find out how old they were.
What hath God wrought?
What hath God wrought? Dude. Yeah, now we can figure out how old we are, dude. Have you ever wondered how old you are? This is wild. This is so funny. This is extreme. This is more extreme than extreme. All right, let's keep this one going.
Unfortunately, there were some people who simply did not wish to know. And that's why, on his way home from the office one night, Gregory was attacked by a rage of henchmen. Making his way through the evening traffic, Gregory notices that the other vehicles, which crowd and bump his little red car, are all inhabited by slowly aging, very hip young people. They appear to be casting sinister glances toward him through their glinting acid burnout eyeballs, trying to run him off the road or make him bump into something, giving strong evidence of hostile aggression. To elude them, Gregory takes the short forest exit off the expressway. They zoom after him in all manner of cars, trucks, garishly painted buses, and motorcycles. Gregory takes a bumpy trail off the main Short Forest Road, which leads him up the side of a famous and conveniently placed mountain and into a strange cave on the edge of a cliff not far from a little twisted tree with eyes on it. Meanwhile, the enraged hunchmen and hunchwomen rumble through the short forest until, realizing the little swine has escaped, they decide to park their steaming vehicles in a circular pseudo-wagon train formation and have a love-in.
What? A love-in?
Under the influence of a fantastic amount of trendy chemical amusement aid, they proceed to perform lewd acts. Each other off with small personal possessions and dance with depraved abandon in the vicinity of a 6-foot pile of transistor radios, each one tuned to a different station.
henchmen finally expire from exhaustion, and Gregory, who has viewed the proceedings from a safe distance, breathes a sigh of relief.
Phew.
Only to be terrified once again by a roar of immense laughter, which seems to be rumbling up from the very depths of the cave in which he has hidden his car.
Good Lord, what was that?
Gregory doesn't realize he has concealed himself inside the very mouth of Billy the Mountain. And as you all know, whenever Billy laughs, rocks and boulders hack up, and the air for miles around is filled with tons of dust, forming a series of huge brown clouds.
Who is making those new brown clouds? Who is making those clouds these days? Who is making those new brown clouds? Better ask a philosopher and see what he says.
Gregory stops at a gas station and makes a mysterious phone call.
Is this the old loft with the paint peeling off it by the Chinese police where the dogs roll by? Is this where they keep the philosophers now with the rugs in the dust where the books go to die? How many has got? So he's got quite a few just sitting around there with nothing to do. Well, I just called you up because I wanted to see a philosopher be of assistance to me.
Gregory receives information that the greatest living philosopher known to mankind is currently in possession of the very information in question. And furthermore, this information could be his if only Gregory would attend a special therapeutic group assembly. Classes now forming and available at a special low, low introductory fee. And now here he is, the greatest living philosopher known to mankind, Quentin Robert D. Nameland. Take it away.
Oh, gosh, dude. I'm naming my first child Philosopher.
All right. Let's jump
back into it.
Folks, as you can see for yourself, the way this clock over here is behaving, time is of affliction. Now, this might be cause for alarm among a portion of you. From a certain experience, I tend to proclaim the eons are closing.
To Quentin Robert D. Nameland, greatest living philosopher known to mankind.
Who is making those new brown clouds? If you ask the philosopher,
Dude, we went dubstep for like a second. Oh. Oh. What did I... Dude, oh gosh. Oh gosh, dude. I don't even know how to start explaining. So I have a few thoughts, right? This is a movie. Dude, this is like a movie in music form, right? Like you can't even... Like this one song deserves a whole documentary, dude. Like the questions I would ask Frank Zappa right now. So did you like it? Yes. Wait, no. I loved it. Yeah, no, seriously though. Oh God, so many elements I can't even quantify right now. Like, yeah, no. You can tell it's like satirical, but like there's still so much organization to it. It's like, it's as impactful of a work as like, say, like, you know, one of the best paintings ever. Dude, one of the best works of art. Dude, this is like top 10. Dude, this is top 5 works of art ever created, dude. Like, holy crap. I kind of want to play that ending again, right? But no, it deserves a whole listen through for a second time and experience. So I'm going to save it. I'm not going to just re-listen to that ending. It blew my mind. This song blew my mind. Yeah, no, what is there to even say? Not much, dude. Frank Zappa was on life. High on life, dude. All right, so let's go thank the gold tier patrons we have. Adam Sanford, Gary Milstead, HRH King Lurks, to Joseph, Wilger, Onyxia, Peter K, Tammy Curtis, Allotrope, Richie G, Tony Allen, TJ, Jim Tatro, Mark Gettemeyer, Karin Graziano, Dirk, Robert D. Hassinger, Brett King, Kips Daly, Jason Unger, and Bob Kern. Thanks to everybody for joining the Patreon crew. Really appreciate you. Couldn't do this without each and every single one of you. So if you want to become part of the Patreon crew, go on over to patreon.com/johnslop, where you can get early access to my videos and help the channel grow even more. Make sure to like and subscribe to me as well. And also make sure to have a good rest of your day, everybody. All right, I'll see you in the next one. Peace.